Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Hope you're all doing good. So after a long time, I'm doing a voiceover video. Hope you'll like it. To know how I created this look, then please keep on watching. To start off with the face, I'm using sunscreen. All the products used in this video will be mentioned in the description box below. Please do check it out. So now for the primer, I'm using the Smashbox Photo Finish Primer. This keeps my face really matte for a long time. And also makes my makeup last for a long time. Now the next step would be the orange corrector. I have a separate video on color correcting in my channel. You can check that out. So taking a dense brush and, you know, trying to blend everything out and applying it wherever I need the concealing. So now after this, I'm taking a damp sponge and taking out any excess product which would have I would have applied on this face, because I want the orange character to be a thin layer. Now just dusting a teeny tiny bit of the translucent powder wherever I get oily, and also wherever I've applied the orange character, so that the concealer doesn't move when I apply the foundation, because these are cream products, so they tend to move around. So I'm just setting very slight teeny tiny bit, not too much of powder, because you're gonna apply cream on top of all this. So the next part of the video is my favorite, like, it's amazing. I learned this technique from Scott Barnes. He's JLo's makeup artist who appeared on my favorite channel, Tari Westbrook's channel. I've been following her since 2015, and she's my everything in makeup. Like, she's my makeup guru. I've not learned professionally through anybody, but she is the one, only person I learn makeup from. Like, she's just amazing. Do check out her channel. She's just amazing on everything. Like, true to what she feels about the product and everything, like product reviews and everything. So, you know, in 2015, I started watching her. Like, it was like my love at first sight about the makeup, and she was just amazing and how genuine she was. Ever since that, I followed. Like, recently, like a couple of months back, Scott Barnes appeared first time on her channel, and you know, and he did this makeup on Tati Westbrook herself. And then the second time he appeared, he explained and he taught and made Tati do it by herself, which made me, like, it inspired me to do this video here, where he basically applies the lighter shade concealer on the highlighting points of the face, like where bridge of the nose, the forehead, center of the forehead, like underneath the eyes and everywhere, wherever I apply here in the video. And a darker shade, contour shade, you know, shade on the hollows of the cheek, just to chisel out your cheekbones, like, so beautifully, like, contoured and amazing. Your face looks slimmer and younger. That's what I feel like when I started doing this. The first time it was a bit, like, you know, difficult for me to blend, but now I find it, like, once everything, blending is a bit difficult when you do too much products like this, but once you're done, it's just amazing. It gives you a really, really different, like, professional look. That's how he does JLo's makeup all the time. Like, it was just amazing and brilliant. So now that I've blended all this, see, my face already looks like so much better. And on top of this, I'm gonna apply the foundation. So all my contouring has been done underneath my foundation. So now I'm blending the foundation using a stippling brush. That's what he taught Tati, that he asked her to use a stippling brush of his own brush line. Since I don't own that, like, obviously I have a Pro Arte stippling brush, which is really, really light on the skin. So you're not gonna move around the contours you applied on the face. You're just gonna, you know, cover them up with the foundation, and still the contours are gonna see through, because the highlighting points are gonna be seen through the foundation, and the contours are gonna be seen through. Very slight motions. Now I'm just blending it with my beauty sponge, just trying to take off any excess product so that everything looks like skin. To this, I'm just baking underneath my eyes with my Laura Mercier translucent setting powder. It's a beautiful powder. Anybody with oily skin, it's like holy grail for me. I'm just baking it underneath because I'll be heading out the whole day today, so I need my makeup to last for a very long time. You can skip this step if you're dry skin or you don't get oily, like, you know, normal and dry skin can skip this step. Now to set the contour, the cream contour which I've applied, I'm using my powder bronzer so that the cream sets in. My face already looks so much slimmer than what it was before. Applying some bronzer on my jawlines as well. So dusting off my excess powder which I was baking underneath my eye. And also I finished off my eye makeup off camera because I was running late. So for my blush, I'm using MAC blush in the shade Fever. This is my favorite blush because this is the only blush which looks natural on my skin. Like, how much ever I apply, it's gonna look like my skin with a flush of color. It's a beautiful color, a beautiful blush for tanned and brown skin beauties. For my highlighter, since it was a daytime, I didn't want, you know, to have a chunk of glitter on my face, so I thought this iridescent powder will have a, you know, kind of subtle glow. And also, if someone comes closer, it won't look like a chunk of glitter on my cheeks. So I opt for this. Not much, just a teeny tiny bit, because anyways, the foundation itself has a subtle glow to it. So to set everything in, I'm using my Murphy setting spray, which is almost over, and I love it. It just melts everything together. Using my lash curler, I'm curling my lashes. And for the mascara, I'm using my NYX What the Hype mascara. Sorry for making weird faces while applying mascara, please forgive me. So I'm just adding some sindoor, which I don't skip at all. And for my lips, I'm using a nude shade from Wet n Wild. See, it's almost over. Like, this is my best nude ever for my skin tone. It's in the shade Gimme Mocha. It's a perfect rosy nude. Yeah, that's my finished look. I just added some bindi and that's it. Hope you liked it. Bye, guys.